ben vanavond op de boekpresentatie van het nieuwe boek van Mathieu Ricard over altruïsme. Hij wordt ook wel the most happy man on earth genoemd. Dus hij moet iets snappen. En hij is vast niet helemaal gelukkig. Nou ja, misschien is hij wel gelukkig begonnen. Maar hoe dan ook, ik ga hem wat tips vragen over of hij überhaupt nog wel eens boos is. Of wat dan ook. Misschien wel helemaal niet. Maar ik ga proberen wat inzichten te krijgen van deze boeddhistische meester. Dus tot later.
Okay, so should I do something?
Psychiatrist.
Yes, please. What is his name?
Martin.
Yeah. Sure, and maybe if you could sign for the chart, we'll have this.
So, for whom I write it?
Well, we thought of this idea of giving it away.
Good, so I just write a sentence.
Exactly, so we don't know for who it is. So thank you so much again for your time.
Welcome.
And so you've been called the most happy man on earth many times.
By journalists.
Yes, sir.
Not by scientists.
It's been haunting you ever since.
Well, not haunting, but it's like a recurrent joke.
It is, yeah.
So it doesn't make sense for science, but you know
yeah.
What to do.
Yeah.
I have to cope with that.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Nothing wrong. No. It's better than being the unhappiest person.
Exactly,
in the world.
Exactly.
But simply, there's no scientific reasons to say that.
Yeah. Okay. That's good. That's good to know. But you have been, of course, researching happiness and.
Yes. Sure.
Subject
of course.
Like, of course, altruism, mm-hmm. Topic of your new book for a while. Mm-hmm. So I was thinking, you are a good person to. You know how to be happy or how to become happy, and I was wondering how, in a way, the three poisons, greed, hatred, and ignorance, how could they help? How could they be of any help on your path to happiness? Could they be of any help?
Well. First, I would say craving, first one. This is just the best way to make you permanently unhappy. Because any other factor, let's say like desire, which is like an aspiration to something, which is, you can aspire to your happiness, you can aspire to others' happiness, there's nothing wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Grasping, it's just spoil the whole wholesome effect of desire and aspiration, and it immediately brings an element of torment.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a crystal glass and ding, and you put your finger, sound is finished.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
The moment grasping and craving sets in, a pleasurable experience, an aspiration for something, a desire for something, if it's with craving, sure, it will be a tormenting aspect.
Mm.
If it's hatred, you create devastation to others, you harm others. It's not anger, it's hatred that is the poison.
Mm-hmm.
So it's wish to harm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then wish to harm, of course, there's not any good aspect. Now, if you speak about anger, there's so many different angers. The anger that goes with malevolence or with hatred, it's of course a source of suffering, but anger that is an indignation facing a massacre, injustice, a child being molested or something. Of course, that's not negative. That's,
mm-hmm.
This is inspired by compassion.
Mm-hmm.
And then ignorance. How can ignorance be brings anything else but suffering?
Mm.
Because the root cause of suffering is distortion of reality. You think that impermanence is permanent, there's a unitary self where there is a continuous dynamic stream of consciousness. So if you distort reality, it's not going to work, it's not going to function. Therefore you end up in suffering because you do things in a way that do not work. So you bump into reality, you suffer.
So one final question. Do you still ever get really pissed off?
You get upset, yes.
You do.
Of course, if you see the massacres in Syria and all that,
yes.
Who will not get upset
exactly.
When you see those cities devastated? But like wish to harm. It's just, I don't think it's conceivable. But I hope many people who are practitioners, they can't even imagine willingly wanting to harm someone. That's
long been gone.
Oh yeah, I hope so. I mean, I cannot imagine wanting to harm willingly. You know, to decide I want to harm someone.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I think it's not doesn't make sense.
Mm.
It's not present.
Wow. So there is hope.
Yes, of course. We all have the potential for that. It is nothing extraordinary. It's just nice. It's good. But you know, it's a long way to go, but at least that is gone.
Okay. You're beautiful,
Henry. Huh?
You're beautiful,
Henry. Nice pain.